Once upon a time there was a sweet little girl. Everyone who saw her liked her, but most of all her grandmother, who did not know what to give the child next. Once she gave her a little cap made of red velvet. Because it suited her so well, and she wanted to wear it all the time, she came to be known as Little Red Riding Hood. One day her mother said to her, "Come, Little Red Riding Hood. Here is a piece of cake and a bottle of wine. Take them to your grandmother. She is sick and weak, and they will do her well. Mind your manners and give her my greetings. Behave yourself on the way, and do not leave the path, or you might fall down and break the glass, and then there will be nothing for your sick grandmother." Little Red Riding Hood promised to obey her mother. The grandmother lived out in the woods, a half hour from the village. When Little Red Riding Hood entered the woods, a wolf came up to her. She did not know what a wicked animal he was, and was not afraid of him. "Good day to you, Little Red Riding Hood."
"Thank you, Wolf.
Where are you going so early, Little Red Riding Hood?"
"To grandmother's."
"And what are you carrying under your apron?"
"Grandmother is sick and weak, and I am taking her some cake and wine. We baked yesterday, and they should give her strength."
"Little Red Riding Hood, just where does your grandmother live?"
"Her house is a good quarter hour from here in the woods, under the three large oak trees. There's a hedge of hazel bushes there."
"You must know the place," said Little Red Riding Hood. The wolf thought to himself, "Now there is a tasty bite for me. Just how are you going to catch her?"
Then he said, "Listen, Little Red Riding Hood, haven't you seen the beautiful flowers that are blossoming in the woods? Why don't you go and take a look? And I don't believe you can hear how beautifully the birds are singing. You are walking along as though you were on your way to school in the village. It is very beautiful in the woods."
Little Red Riding Hood opened her eyes and saw the sunlight breaking through the trees and how the ground was covered with beautiful flowers. She thought, "If I take a bouquet to grandmother, she will be very pleased. Anyway, it is still early, and I'll be home on time." And she ran off into the woods looking for flowers. Each time she picked one, she thought that she could see an even more beautiful one a little way off, and she ran after it, going further and further into the woods. But the wolf ran straight to the grandmother's house and knocked on the door.
"Who's there?"
"Little Red Riding Hood. I'm bringing you some cake and wine. Open the door for me."
"Just press the latch," called out the grandmother.
"I'm too weak to get up."
The wolf pressed the latch, and the door opened. He stepped inside, went straight to the grandmother's bed, and ate her up. Then he took her clothes, put them on, and put her cap on his head. He got into her bed and pulled the curtains shut.
Little Red Riding Hood had run after flowers, and did not continue on her way to grandmother's until she had gathered all that she could carry. When she arrived, she found, to her surprise, that the door was open. She walked into the parlor, and everything looked so strange that she thought, "Oh, my God, why am I so afraid? I usually like it at grandmother's." Then she went to the bed and pulled back the curtains. Grandmother was lying there with her cap pulled down over her face and looking very strange.
"Oh, grandmother, what big ears you have. All the better to hear you with.
Oh, grandmother, what big eyes you have. All the better to see you with.
Oh, grandmother, what big hands you have. All the better to grab you with.
Oh, grandmother, what a horribly big mouth you have. All the better to eat you with." And with that he jumped out of bed, jumped on top of poor Little Red Riding Hood, and ate her up. As soon as the wolf had finished this tasty bite, he climbed back into bed, fell asleep, and began to snore very loudly. A huntsman was just passing by. He thought it strange that the old woman was snoring so loudly, so he decided to take a look. He stepped inside, and in the bed there lay the wolf that he had been hunting for such a long time. "He has eaten the grandmother, but perhaps she still can be saved. I won't shoot him," thought the huntsman. So he took a pair of scissors and cut open his belly. He had cut only a few strokes when he saw the red cap shining through. He cut a little more,
and the girl jumped out and cried, "Oh, I was so frightened. It was so dark inside the wolf's body." And then the grandmother came out alive as well. Then Little Red Riding Hood fetched some large heavy stones. They filled the wolf's body with them, and when he woke up and tried to run away, the stones were so heavy that he fell down dead. The three of them were happy. The huntsman took the wolf's pelt. The grandmother ate the cake and drank the wine that Little Red Riding Hood had brought. And Little Red Riding Hood thought to herself, "As long as I live, I will never leave the path and run off into the woods by myself if mother tells me not to."
Review non-special, Mimea Sekor 135 f2.8 format, 35mm SLR. Type, prime lens. Focusing, manual focus, MF lens mounts, M42, M42 specifications, focal length 135mm max. Aperture f/2.8mm, aperture f/22 blades 8mm, focus m/1.3 filter m/55 weight gr/oz 310/10, 9 length m/n86/3, 4 auto Mimea Sekor 135mm f/2.8 fast telephoto prime lens for a 35mm SLR with m42 screw mount. There are two versions of the lens, one with built-in hood, and 8th blades aperture, minimum focus 1.8 meters. Now I review version 1/2 with built-in hood, and 8th blades aperture and minimum focus 1.3 meters. I have a Mimea / Sekor TL2.8-135 and the rendering is similar to your SX lens. Perhaps your lens has more contrast and mine has 8 blades not 6. Very good at f/2.8-3.52. Until then, a few more from the man. I still haven't tried anything else than the 2.8 setting. In good light it's reasonably sharp, and the bokeh is good. One thing that I've noticed though is that the man needs lots of light. It's not too good at micro contrast and fine contrast details. The following are at 2.8, short medium distance and afternoon sun. -50% magnification crops. I won't compare it to the Carl Zeiss Gen I haven't got. I just found on internet that the Mimea is a copy of the Rolliner, then that the Rolliner in question was just a bit less sharper than the Carl Zeiss in a test in an old German photo magazine, but it is faster. I don't know if it is the exact term, since we don't speak of speed in French, than it. And I doubt, I try to justify my choice, there is such a big difference at f/5.6 or f/8. So I think that it is a very good lens for the price. Now a photo taken with it. A poor one I know, but I find it quite sharp. It was taken at f/8. As soon as I got a decent photo with the lens full open, I'll share it. I cannot compare with any other lenses of the same size, but I found it sharper than the Helios, a bit darker, but I suspect the Mimea to be less sensible to flare, because the pictures have a better contrast.